Okay, well, I'm fresh out of ideas here.
Let's just blow stuff up. Welcome to Michael Bay Edition 2.0. This is in celebration of the second Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles trailer that was released today.
Oh, there was a second one today?
Yeah, did you guys see the trailer? You didn't see the trailer?
No.
You don't want to see it. It's bad.
Good.
It's so fucking bad, dude. I was watching it and just my jaw dropped at how stupid that movie looks. It's just god awful.
I really, to be honest, I hope it tanks.
It
I don't
won't.
Want kids. I don't want kids these days to grow up thinking that's the TMNT.
No, dude. It's so bad. Oh, it hurt my soul to watch it. They so like Donatello's got way too many gadgets going on here.
Was he too smart?
No, he's got gadgets. He's like Q.
Oh, gosh.
And, he's got, like, they have a home base that's full of computer screens and shit. And it tells them, you know, that it's like their intelligence center, and they're able to track the Foot Clan's movements with it or some shit. I don't know.
That's weird.
All I know is that they were looking at a bunch of screens. They got you got these really shitty Michael Bay angles where you can't really tell what the hell's going on because you're halfway behind everything.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's like the Foot Clan's on the move. We got to get going, guys, or some shit like that. And you get these stupid, horrible cutscenes that don't tell you very much, but tell you just enough to know that it's gonna suck.
Gosh.
But the thing that just sucks about it, man, is Shredder. Shredder looks like a fucking Transformer.
What?
He's all shiny Transformer metal, like the fucking Transformer movies. And it's all mechanized and shit, and it's just not right.
That's unfortunate. There's so much stuff you could do with those movies, and just the way he's taking it is no bueno.
It's just the worst direction to go. It's pathetic.
I can hear my childhood dying.
Yeah, I mean, I'm taking this one right in the childhood.
That's painful. That doesn't grow back.
Nope.
I wonder.
So yeah. So in response to that horrible abortion of a movie that's being made, we're just gonna blow things up. That was the point of all of that.
Oh, so much faster. Yes.
What?
I got a splash potion of swiftness.
That's a good point.
It's super fast. Still have to click a lot, but, you know. Yeah. Holy crap, that's a lot of explosion.
That was fun.
That was so evil. Boop, boop, boop.
Boop, 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 boop. The mouse stress test is back.
Yeah. Episode 2 of Click As Fast As You Can. I'm actually really annoyed with how much my mouse clicks.
You don't
like
the
it.
Sound? You're just like, oh,
I
keep
so
making
much.
Clicking sounds. Urgh. I don't know if it's clicking unless it makes clicking sounds and it makes me angry.
But really, like, why do mice have to click so loudly? I don't understand.
Because you're pushing down a mechanical button.
I know that, but there's got to be a way to make it less noisy. There has to be.
I don't know. I think you would find it to be unsatisfactory if it didn't click.
I don't think so, to
be
honest.
I think you'd be like, this mouse, it doesn't feel right when I click it because it doesn't make a clicky sound. Like, it would...
So you're saying I'm so accustomed to the click that I wouldn't like it otherwise?
No, I'm thinking that it's built into human beings now.
Well, I guess I'm not a human being then, because I don't want it anymore.
No, hear me out on this. So you have, have you ever pushed a button and it didn't feel like you pushed it?
You didn't know if it did anything?
Okay, hang on. I guess you're not understanding me. I don't mind the click. I just don't want it to click this much.
Okay, well, you know, I can understand that,
It's too much. It's like, I don't know. I don't even know what to compare it to. It's so obnoxious.
And the problem is,
when I want to do something, I have to click. So it's like I'm torturing myself, and I can't do anything about it.
See, the thing that I'm saved with here is that I'm wearing a headset, and it's a round my ear kind of headset. So I don't hear the clicks as much.
Well, for the sake of anybody who's watching, they're probably listening to it too.
Oh, yeah, they're probably listening to it, and they're probably going, God, all those fucking clicks, man, these people suck.
Yeah, right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So, what was that guy's name that recommended we do this, by the way? Because we were clearing this, if anyone recalls from the first video, if you even watched the first video, we're clearing this out to make a giant horse track.
Yeah.
I cannot remember that guy's name. He was really nice guy. He was watching Ron's Twitch stream.
Yeah.
During one of our Twitches where we were just Minecrafting.
I'm gonna check really quick. And, I feel bad that I've forgotten it, but there's a remedy, so I'll
shout out
it.
To that one guy that said that thing that made us do this.
Hang on.
Props.
That was probably way too low. That's gonna just blow a hole in the fucking bedrock.
Let's see.
There you go.
Was it Rekfiz?
I think it was Rex, wasn't it?
Rekfiz was his name, so we ended up calling him Rek.
No, we called him Rex, I think.
Well, his name is Rekfiz, so I don't know why I would have said Rex, to be honest.
I think that was his Twitch name, wasn't it?
No, it's Rekfiz. I just said it.
I don't remember you ever saying Rekfiz.
Yeah, that's his name. I always called him Rek.
Okay.
Speaking of Twitch, I want to start Twitching some more.
Twitch more.
Probably this weekend. I'll do it again. Probably Saturday. I want to make it more. What?
I could Twitch.
I wish I could Twitch stream more, but I got too many things going on the weekends, and that's you know it's prime family time. So.
You see, that's the problem. I suddenly find myself without anything to do. For most of the morning.
Yep. That's what I was doing with my time before I got a part-time job.
So what are you doing now?
Me? Yeah. I work at a store downtown.
Where's the Vandal store downtown?
Yeah, for the university.
Right.
Wow, it is darker than dicks down here.
Like, what kind of dicks? Like, Ethiopian dicks?
Like
those
bigger, blacker
dicks.
I say it can't be like Rom's because his dick's pretty white.
Oh, that's the wrong stone. There we go.
Yeah, so the excitement of today was I got laid off.
Awesome.
Yeah. That's what I thought.
Well, you gotta say why. It's not like you were doing a bad job.
There just wasn't enough work.
Yeah.
That does happen.
Yeah. It was just one of those places that they didn't have enough work for how many people were there, so they're like, we can't hire you, or we can't have you on right now, but we'll hire you later when we get more. So
we
it's not like
maybe.
It's...
Huh.
Okay,
the likelihood of me actually getting hired on again in a timely manner, I feel, is low.
Probably not high, yeah. But, you know...
Yeah, so fuck me.
That's a thing. Kind of came out of nowhere, too. It's kind of sad.
It like the end of the day, and he's like, hey, can we come chat in my office? And I was like, yeah. And he's like, so our workload is really slowed down, and we're going to have to let you go.
That's such a... God. You're going to get paid, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let's not blow things up over here, because I'm trying to clear the water out so it stops falling everywhere.
Ah.
And if you blow stuff up over here, it's going to blow up my blocks.
Speaking of which, did you see the new block that they're putting in that I'm really excited about? Aside from the
slime.
Yeah, did you see the sponge? It's actually being
used. I saw the sponge. I'm really excited about that.
It soaks up water.
I think Sethling was showing something about it, wasn't he?
Yeah,
he showed the underwater fortresses.
Yeah.
That too. Yeah.
Seem like they're going to be really cool, but they're going to be hard to navigate in survival because drowning.
Well, they're also adding those new potions that you can walk underwater and hold your breath longer and stuff. So
it's going to work out pretty well, actually. It'll be pretty easy. You just got to be able to brew yourself some
potions. Oh, it's
going to
get dark.
Yeah, I'm excited for the sponge block. I just want sponge blocks.
Yeah, me too. That's going to be so much easier to clear out water.
Right? It's just
sponge block.
I knew that joke was coming.
I'm just surprised John wasn't the one that made it.
I just want to see Michael Bay SpongeBob now.
Didn't even think of that.
This will probably look like a fucking Transformer.
So are you guys using TNT? Because that would make it Michael Bay. At this point, I'm more like Chuck Norris at this point.
I'm using TNT.
I've been using TNT, but now I'm trying to clean up the water, so I'm actually putting down more blocks to blow up.
Oh,
Michael
I see.
Bay
okay.
And the shit out of this.
So Katie's Michael Bay. I'm Chuck Norris.
And I'm
Bob
the Builder.
Yeah, there you go.
He can fix it. Yes, he.
I was thinking more Kevin Costner because of Waterworld, but that's a shitty movie. So.
Hey, I love that movie.
Really? Yeah.
I love it because it's just so ridiculous.
That's a great reason.
It's over the top, but it's actually pretty good other than the end. Other than the ending, that movie is actually pretty fantastic.
Finger workout.
Kevin Costner's probably one of my favorite actors for apocalypse movies.
Really?
Just because it just doesn't work for him, and that makes me happy. I mean, it kind of actually does. He did that stretch of them where it's all he did was, after the apocalypse movies, and it kind of made me happy. I don't know. It was my thing. I really dug it. Like when he did The Postman. The Postman's like one of my all-time favorite movies.
That's amazing. Huh. It's got some pretty horrible reviews from some people.
Oh God, I know, but it's. It's not that it had to be good, it's just it's comfortable with what it is, and it makes me happy.
Yeah. It's one of those movies that actually follows through with its title.
Yeah, it is exactly
it is
what
literally
it's supposed
a water
to be. Like, all his movies end up being that way, you know? And it works for me. I'm just like, yeah, you know? He lives in a water world, he is a postman. I mean, what else do you want?
Yeah. Let's see, can't he breathe underwater or something? Isn't there something
special?
Yeah,
he's like evolved to have fish gills and shit.
That's so cool. I think that'd be awesome.
And like webbed feet and stuff. And so he's like the only one that knows what's actually going on. Because everyone's just like, there's got to be dry land somewhere. We have all these weird, strange artifacts, but nobody understands what's going on or where anything came from. But since he can swim underwater all the way to the depths, he's found all the cities and shit underground. Or underwater.
Yeah.
That's probably my favorite scene when he takes that chick down in the little diver globe.
Mm-hmm. And shows him the cities.
Yeah, and then the there's like submarines and shit crashed into skyscrapers. I don't know, it just makes me happy. I was like, yeah, that's great.
There's a...
I mean, it's total environmentalist propaganda, but it's just wonderful.
It kind of makes me think of... like Book of Eli, but
God, I love that movie too.
Oh, that's a great movie.
But
love that too.
You can't but not love Denzel though. Anyway, so
no. Yeah, that movie blew my mind. Like the first time I saw it.
I know, right? At the end, and you're just like, "What? Wait, what? Awesome!"
He's been the whole time.
Spoilers, what? By the way.
Yeah, sorry. Should have said something.
Yeah, it's cool. I just haven't seen it or anything.
Seen what? Waterworld?
With Eli. Or Waterworld. No. I haven't seen either of them.
I might just put a bleep on there.
You should. He's been beep the whole time. Censored.
That's exactly what I'm gonna do.
We should do like an unnecessary censorship episode. That'd be so funny.
That would be fun. Look for it next week. Not really.
Speaking of next week, when are we getting soccer out?
I have no idea.
We need to get that tournament going.
I can't tie anyone down for it other than you guys. It's hard as hell to get anyone tied down to actually do it.
Well, I guess we don't have to do a tournament. We could just make it a thing.
We'll just do a couple videos.
Yeah, just do the between the three of us. Yeah.
And you know, for our viewers, just so you know, I have actually read the rules for soccer now.
Yeah, he's not a complete idiot American anymore.
No, I'm still a complete idiot American. I'm just saying I now know the rules for soccer. Don't rob me my identity, Rom. Jesus.
That's so okay. American that game was embarrassing. You're like, yeah, I totally know what this is. Blah, blah, blah.
I know what it is for other sports.
Oh, God, it's getting dark.
I just didn't know it for soccer.
Where am I? Am I ever going to come out of this? What the hell? Oh, there you am. Wow, that was a long tunnel.
I just had a minor Gavin moment. I don't know why you gotta keep bringing it up.
A Gavin moment? Oh, moment?
Yeah.
Did you shit your pants?
5 times in a day?
Not recently, but it's after.
Did you hear about that? Did you see that?
I did. To be perfectly honest, though, I have had those types of Gavin moments, too. I used to work at a veterinary hospital, and we worked with cows, and there's some sort of sickness that cows can get that's transferable to humans. Mm-hmm. But in humans, it just causes, like, really bad diarrhea for a month.
Oh.
You got cow shits?
So I had cow shits. I was making cow patties for a month. And the day that I, like, had one solid movement, I was just like, yes!
Wait,
fucking
so
awesome.
You weren't making patties if it was...
I was making soup.
Puddles.
Making soup. Cow soup.
When it dries, it turns into
I think that's
patty.
Called beef stew. That's a different thing.
So yeah. Anyway. So after a month of this, right, I think I'm all safe and shit because I've had a dump that's all solid. And I go to rip a fart and just shit my pants. We're like getting ready to go to a movie or something. I don't remember what it was. And I just go to just rip a normal fart, thinking it was going to be all good, and just full on, full pressure, shit my pants.
No.
Yeah, it was awesome.
How did you have one solid shit and think you were safe?
I don't know. Just didn't occur to me. Told you it was a Gavin moment.
Oh, goodness.
So, yeah.
That poor guy.
I know, I feel bad for him.
That's awful. I can't even imagine, like, pooping yourself on an airplane. It's like, who has the forethought to have...
There's a problem down below.
Wait, what? Oh, you mean... Oh, gotcha. But, I mean, who has the forethought to bring an extra pair of underwear with
you? Well, now Gavin does.
Yeah, I might just start doing that in case something happens. Was that lava? Where did that come from? I just saw it out of the corner of my eye.
Oh, that's the problem down below.
Below? Oh. It makes it sound like you're taking a plane to Australia or something.
What if your eyes
down
didn't
under.
Have corners?
Eye corners?
What if your eyes didn't have corners?
Well, they don't, technically.
So you know what I mean? Like, what if they were just actually perfectly round? Your eye sockets. Well, like, the skin around, you know? Your eyelids.
So, what you're saying is you want this to be, like, a me. We'd be like me's from the Wii universe. Because there's some very round eyes on those characters.
Yes.
They're kind of scary. Makes me wonder if there are people out there with actually round eyes.
Well, the only it people I can think of typically have a chromosomal disorder, and so...
Really?
Well, Down syndrome children don't have any epicanthal folds, so they got that more smooth eye look, and they typically look a little rounder.
Oh, really?
In the eyes.
Huh.
But, I mean, what if we all looked like that, and then nobody would know? It'd be kind of cool. No discrimination. I don't know.
Yeah, what if autism is the norm? Ooh.
Yeah.
Ah! Stupid gravel. What if we're dreaming about it?
If your mom is dreaming about it.
And then I had to get a tattoo to remember it.
Did you watch Memento recently?
Son
or something?
Of a bitch!
No, I was just combining movies, though.
Okay.
It worked out in my head.
Oh, did you see that they're going to make a 12 Monkeys TV show?
I did, actually. I haven't seen that whole movie through.
Really? You've not seen the whole way through? It's so good.
Mm-mm.
What you find out at the end is just awesome. I mean, you totally find out.
What you find out?
I'm not even going to put it in. So, yeah, I mean, but it's pretty good at the end. It's really freaking cool.
I will have to go back and watch that.
We're gonna watch it tonight, actually. As soon as I finish with this, we're going to go watch it, which I should probably finish soon. We're pretty close to having this mountain done.
Are we really? I haven't been paying attention. I've been tunneling out the bottom.
Yeah, dude, it's almost gone. Really, we could stop almost where we're at. Because we got a lot of space here.
Really? Should we...
Should come out and look at it, man.
Well, just a second. Power through. Boosh, 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 boosh.
But yeah, the, it's...
Oh, dang, yeah.
They're gonna make a TV show out of it. It's gonna be on Sci-Fi, though, so, I mean, it could either be really good or really shitty.
Oh, God, sci-fi shows.
It'll probably have great writing. It'll probably have great writing and really shitty effects.
I think one of the worst movies I've ever seen was a sci-fi movie.
Yeah, their movies are usually pretty shitty, but their TV shows are not so bad.
They do that on purpose. They're probably the only ones that would show those movies.
Yeah.
Lake Placid 3.
Which is what they're known for, and they get people who watch them, like me. I've watched them just for fun.
I've watched a lot of stuff on sci-fi.
They're so bad that you love them.
Yeah. Well, they make, like, the best campy sci-fi.
Yeah, yeah. Ugh, much stone. Wow, I cannot wait to actually start building this track.
I know, right?
Instead of just destroying a mountain. Being one with the mountain.
We're not being one with the mountain. We're being so American with this mountain.
Captain Kirk is climbing the mountain. Why is he climbing?
Ah! Okay, there we go. That is a very large open area.
Hey, Romp.
Oh. Yo.
I wanted to show you this.
No, I want to be in the middle of that. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? No.
Yeah.
What happened?
Hey, thanks for watching Plus One Play with us. I hope you had a good time.
Oh.
Night.
Night.
Or day.
It could be morning.
Oh. Since we usually go in the mornings. Anyway, bye. That was fun.